Right, so we have to be proactive, we have to get that plan done for the township. We have to understand what it's gonna be with 19 new developments coming to Cecil Township. Can we handle that? Can our schools handle that? Don, you were addressing that, you know, will our schools even take the amount of people that we've approved that are coming into Cecil Township? So it's a big picture.
Thank goodness we don't have to worry about that, though, with the schools, that we have the school board to worry about.
But the school board is only allowed to build up to 10% of the growth. And our school board, I don't know, I should go to more of their meetings, but they build these wings, and these wings, well, they should be building structures that go up, and then you add on three stories at a time, and you add children, and you make campuses like you do over in South Fayette. But we need ideas, we need budget input, we need more ideas from Dawn on how to make Cecil better.
You're not seeing traffic like we used to at the road, Rich.
Right.
If there are anybody from down here in the morning, 5 or 6 o'clock home, you know.
Right.
Try to go off the side road, get on 50, it's almost impossible.
So I do applaud our officers, but I also know that we have fire departments that we're gonna have to handle this influx of 19 new developments that are coming to the township. What does that mean?
I think there's
a lot of things.
I think the firemen have been doing a fine job without the township getting involved.
Well, you know what, I wanted to make a comment, as Sean made, about him not needing a study. If you just listen to what we say, we've all consented to it, the study's gonna be done. We can't wait till it's done with, so it's finally over and done with. But when it's over and done with, you're gonna find out that we know what we need. We absolutely know what we need. And I bet if we each wrote down a list of things that we needed for each individual departments, we'd be really close to what that study, because we know what's out there.
Right.
So why don't we do that? Because we keep putting this study, we're kicking this can down the road.
It's supposed to be happening in January.
It was supposed to happen in July, it was supposed to happen in May, it was supposed to happen last January.
Yeah, they put it off because of the budget.
Huh? It's not our fault, I'm not blaming Dawn or anybody, but the state isn't in a hurry to give us money to do a fire study. So we can sit around waiting for a study, or we can talk to the people like you guys and Sean, who know the department and know what the township needs, instead of sitting here and saying stuff that...
But I don't think it's really going to stand yet. What we say is the state authority people come in and say, well, you need a 120-foot platform truck that sits over at Southbury, and you need a building to keep that truck in,
right.
And you need a whole staff of, that truck doesn't go out unless there's two people to operate that truck, just not one person going out. Those trucks don't operate with one person.
But Tony, you know the study does more than just tell you what piece of equipment you need.
Oh, I know. It's going to tell you what's going to cost you for a fireman. It's going to tell you what it's going to cost for all.
It does how to work together, save some areas to save money and things like that. I mean, there's a lot too besides what you need. All right. Anybody else on any other subject? Yes, sir.
But I think whatever I agree with Ronnie said up there about our police. I lived in this township my entire life. I've been fireman for 46 years. And I'm going to tell you right now, Mr. Sivavec, you better do some real hard thinking before you plan on getting rid of any of our police officers.
Yeah, no. Don't jump to conclusion. I don't know where you're getting your facts, but help us build this all together. Help us build this budget and put together and handle the future. I'm an advocate. Our police department is one of the best. And I'll make that statement. Don't laugh at me.
I'm not laughing.
Don't walk me and don't cause any issues, Mr. Solicitor. Advisor against causing animosity amongst the board members, please.
All right, let's get another floor. Go ahead.
Has anybody heard from the State Department about the turnpike? Has anybody tried to contact them to get a meeting with them?
To what regard, John?
The map, the location, the turnover of Rising Road to the township.
Yeah, those maps have existed for...
Okay, so Cecil Township's going to get Rising Road, correct?
No.
Piece of it.
We'll get Cecil Rising Road.
Okay.
And a portion of what, if you consider Rising Road now in its current configuration, essentially from where it meets at 980 to the top of where Pap Road meets.
Okay.
That segment there would become a township.
Are you going to have PennDOT fix that before it gets turned over to you guys?
Yes.
At any time frame of this construction?
No, we don't have any details. We just know what the preliminary plans are.
Bill, do you have any plans for the winter, doing what you did last year at the intersection of Rising and Sunset with the salt? Like you did last year, if it's icy, because that gets very icy because of the water drain runoff down the hill and it crosses over Rising.
My driver over there usually applies salt to that.
Okay.
So we'll continue.
You did it last year, I just want to make sure you're going to do it again.
Cecil Rising Road, I went with Mike Haberman from beginning of the month, I think it was October 6th, and we created a punch list for PennDOT. As conditions to us accepting that road, they have to make some improvements or upgrades, or at least generate enough money for those improvements to be made. So
you, could I see that list of what you plan on having PennDOT fix before it gets turned over?
No.
That's not Cecil Rising, right?
Yeah, I'm talking about from top of Rising to the end of 980.
We don't have that list.
We don't have that list.
There's nothing that's been generated yet.
Okay, because that part's the bad part around that bend where Sunset is, because it gets very icy right there because of the runoff.
Their intent is to make improvements on it before they...
Well, I'm just worried about this year because next year, who knows?
We take all the complaints about PennDOT roads and we do get it to them. Sometimes we do a little work on them, but we shouldn't have to do work on PennDOT roads. But we call them when there's an issue.
Well, I think you should call them again and tell them to come out and fix it.
They will. Yeah, you do work with trying to depend on the respond, don't you?
I do.
We should have to do the roads.
Yeah. You should look at Muse Bishop, too, going down towards in front of Don's house. His water ran off there constantly.
And they've been
constantly.
Yeah, they're repeatedly called on that.
Well, I'm just worried about because there's a school bus stop right there.
Nothing's being done.
Yeah.
You had to go to a PennDOT meeting, raise hell with him there.
Hey, I'll go along with that.
Good luck, we'll never have meetings. All right, anybody else? All right, we appreciate you coming out. There being no further business, this meeting is declared adjourned. Thank you.